What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you the 5 new features in Vue 5 for SketchUp. Let's get started. First, let's download Vue 5. You can go to chaosgroup.com and click here to join the Vue 5 for SketchUp beta. I will leave the link in the description box below as well. After you click on it, you can sign in or sign up if you don't have a chaosgroup account yet. Then you can choose to apply for the beta as a business, student, educator, or an individual. After that, you can download and install Vue 5. Now let's get into the new features. Number 1. Improved Sun and Sky Model. In Vue 5, the Sun and Sky Model has been improved. You can select the new Sky Model here. There is also a new Custom Orientation Control. This will allow you to override the shadow settings in SketchUp, which makes it a lot easier to control the sun angle without changing the orientation of your SketchUp model. As you can see, the improved sun and sky model is a lot more accurate, which will allow you to create more realistic renders, especially during sunrise and sunset. I personally really like the addition of the custom orientation control. It is just a lot more intuitive to control the sunlight, but you can always switch back to using SketchUp shadows by turning this off if you like. Number 2. Light Gen. On your Vue Light toolbar, there's a new button called Light Gen or Light Generator, which is a new Vue tool that automatically generates thumbnails of your SketchUp scene where each one presents a unique lighting scenario. After you launch it, you can choose either exterior or interior. And here you can set the altitude and azimuth variations. When you multiply these values, you will get the number of variants. And finally, you can choose the thumbnail size. I will leave it at the default value. When you're ready, click here to start generating the thumbnails. It will take a while depending on the number of variants and the speed of your computer. After it's done, you can see the thumbnails with different lighting scenarios. When you click on one of them, the lighting will change accordingly, and you can see it updates in the lighting tab. Just choose whichever you like the most, and you're ready to render. For exterior, you also have the option to use HDR for lighting. Here you can choose the number of unique styles, variations, seed value, and thumbnail size. The HDR option is super powerful, as you can see, because Vue automatically creates a lot of realistic skies options for your scene. As you can see, the new Light Gen tool is a great way to quickly find the best lighting that fits your style without having to spend hours on test rendering. Also, there's an option to save the Light Gen variations, so you can load them again later, which can save a lot of time. Pretty cool, huh? Number 3. Light Mix. Another new feature related to lighting is the new Light Mix feature, which allows you to adjust the lights in your scene even after you render. First, open up the Asset Editor and go to the Render Elements tab. Then right-click and add a Light Mix render element. If you expand the right flyout panel, you can choose whether you want to group the lights individually, which is similar to this list here, or you can group by instances, layers, and light IDs. I would just leave it as individual lights. Now you can render your scene as normal. When your render is finished, you will see a list of layers on the right side of the Vue frame buffer window in the compositing section. Now select the source light mix layer, and you will see all of the lights within this mix. This is where you can see the true power of the light mix feature by turning on and off each light. You can see that the scene updates immediately. You can also interactively adjust the brightness of each light by dragging these arrows up and down or type in a specific value. Another cool feature is that you can click here to change the color of your light. You can see that not only does it change the light, but it also changes how the light affects the surrounding objects. When adjusting the light mix, you should consider saving the preset to a file in case you need it later. This will allow you to create different lighting scenarios very easily. And in the future, you can use this button to load the light mix presets. If there are multiple light mix presets in one folder, then Vue will automatically load all the presets here. Once you are done adjusting the light mix settings, you can export the image as normal, or you can send the light mix to composite. This will break them into layers, which you can use to composite further using the new V-Ray frame buffer window. This takes me to the next new feature, new V-Ray frame buffer. In V-Ray 5, the V-Ray frame buffer has been redesigned and now has a lot more powerful features such as built-in compositing. For example, we can add a hue and saturation adjustment layer to one of the lights to change its color. This is non-destructive and can easily be moved to a different layer. Another thing we can do is add one of our render elements as a layer. I will add the extra text render element that I have inserted a dirt map, which I can use to add ambient occlusion. Normally, this process has to be done in other photo editing softwares like Photoshop, but now you can easily do it inside of the new V-Ray frame buffer. This is why it's so powerful. And those are just a few things that you can do with the new V-Ray frame buffer. I will make a more in-depth tutorial on this later. And finally, my favorite and also the biggest new feature in V-Ray 5 is V-Ray Vision, which is basically V-Ray in real time. You can start it by clicking this button here on the V-Ray toolbar. It will take a while to load your scene, depending on the size of your model and the speed of your computer. First, I will place this window and the SketchUp window side by side like so, to make it easier to see. Here you will see a completely new window that looks a bit like V-Ray Interactive Render, but it's a lot faster. You can see that V-Ray Vision is syncing with SketchUp, but the views don't match perfectly. So you can go up here and change to a different resolution mode. This one will match the aspect ratio setting, which you can set in the render output. If you change it in the V-Ray settings, it will update in V-Ray Vision. The next mode will match the scene resolution, which you can change here, and it will be updated in V-Ray Vision. And the third option is Fit in Window. I usually like to use the Match Aspect Ratio mode and set it to 1:1 aspect ratio, then also turn on the Save Frame. This will ensure that the two viewports will match perfectly. As you have already seen, V-Ray Vision syncs with SketchUp, so you can move your SketchUp scene and Vision will sync with it. But you can also navigate in the V-Ray Vision window using the left mouse button to orbit the model. Dragging the right mouse button will allow you to zoom in and out, and dragging the middle mouse will let you pan the model. You can also change from orbit mode to fly mode with this button here, or by pressing tab on your keyboard. While in fly mode, you can move around with WASD or move up and down with E and Q. You can also move faster by holding down the spacebar while moving, or you can adjust the fly speed in the settings with the slider or type in a specific value. There are also other settings such as auto exposure and exposure value compensation to adjust the optimal brightness for your scene. To adjust the lighting of your scene in V-Ray Vision, you can use the SketchUp shadow settings, or you can also hold shift and drag the left mouse button left and right to change the sun's azimuth, and drag up and down to change the altitude. Holding shift and dragging the right mouse will let you adjust the sun's intensity, however, you need to turn off auto exposure to make this work correctly. There are many more shortcuts that you can use, which you can see here. As you can see, V-Ray Vision can help you visualize designs in real time while working in SketchUp. Note that V-Ray Vision is very new, so there are still some limitations. But this is a super exciting thing that KS Group is working on, and I expect great improvements in the future. Anyway, those are the top 5 features in V-Ray 5 for SketchUp Beta. Like I mentioned before, I will probably do a more in-depth tutorial for each of these new features in the future. That's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and comment below and let me know which one is your favorite feature. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.